I love the idea that Yah is always courting us. As a man patiently courts a woman that he desires and intends to make his wife, with a certain quiet certainty. And isn't that so attractive, ladies? If you've never experienced it, trust me, it is.
You're the king! And you're invited to
Greetings. It is just after 11 here on the East Coast in New England. I really move as the spirit leads, as Yah and his Ruach leads. And I just followed the promptings to come before you today to share a bit about repentance and fasting. I made a post on my Instagram. I shared a post, a repost of my Instagram yesterday about the benefits of fasting. And I was surprised, although I shouldn't have been, to the glory of Yah, I'm surprised at the amounts of responses in my DMs to that particular story share. And it has blessed me so much that so many people that have supported me and supported my page and followed and subscribed to my page, many of which I haven't even had in my DMs before. And from all backgrounds and walks of life, this was the post that they responded to, all to the glory of Yah. So there were many questions about fasting and a desire to fast. And it was wonderful to me that they had never tried fasting before. This is something that I've been familiar with since early childhood, something that was normalized in my family, well, at least by my mother, I will say. At first, I was like, oh, wow, you know, because I kind of assumed, even in my spiritual journey outside of biblical truth, I knew fasting to be a practice implemented even by those who practice pagan beliefs and other spiritual paths. So the idea that so many people from different backgrounds were inquiring about fasting and had never fasted before, it really encouraged me. And I knew that there was such a deeper work and Yah was leading me in such a deeper way in the ministry of which Hadaragare has now become and shifted so beautifully into. With that being said, some of you may have noticed some changes with Hadaragare, not only aesthetic changes and rebranding, the website changes and edits, some of the product availability and descriptions, and changes to many of the services and classes. This is reflective of the profound transformation that has occurred in my life very rapidly and radically and very recently. Although I've always had a love for Yah, and he has been courting me, as I said, even through my search in different spiritual paths, recently, just the anointing, the deliverance, the love that I feel and my capacity to receive and accept and believe that love has so greatly expanded. I love the idea that Yah is always courting us. As a man patiently courts a woman that he desires and intends to make his wife, with a certain quiet certainty. And isn't that so attractive, ladies? If you've never experienced it, trust me, it is. When a man with quiet confidence, not aggressive, not thirsty, as they say, pursues you with a knowing. Like, yes, she's mine. She will be mine. She will accept me. And the determination to show how much he values you and loves you through his pursuit, through his giving, as a gentleman, never forceful, never boastful, patient, long-enduring, and just naturally showing up consistently, giving and providing and protecting until we, as the beloved pursued, agree to his choosing. I do believe the man chooses and pursues. The woman accepts in her receptivity. There's an inverted doctrine these days about feminine choice paradigms and the idea that a woman can have multiple partners and one day somehow choose the man she desires. This is erroneous and destructive and a distraction to deviate from our actual role and embodiment of femininity. And ironically, it is taught by many so-called femininity coaches. It is the man's role to do, to choose, and to pursue. It is the masculine energy to do, choose, and pursue. Woman, in the feminine energy of receptivity, accepts. Now, of course, there is a consent in this acceptance and receptivity. There is a yielding in this receptivity. However, the choosing is the man's to do. Choosing a wife whom he has found in well-doing. Not a wife who is seeking, because even in the seeking, that itself is action-driven. It is a pursuit, it is a chase that in and of itself is masculine and aggressive. Feminine receptivity and acceptance, agreeableness, that is the energy we strive to embody. Not only as women who may be seeking actual physical divine masculines or kingdom spouses or husbands, more importantly, as the human soul, the heart longing for union with the ultimate divine masculine, Yah himself, the creator, who has chosen us from the beginning, the good father, the good husband, who has always chosen us and accepted us and loved us unconditionally from the beginning as exactly who we are, have always been, and whom he knows we will be according to his will, word, and destiny. I'm just going to breathe into that. That may have been a torrent of revelation for some, that some may need to take a pause and breath to process. And as I move and speak by the Ruach's flow in my femininity and fluidity, I don't plan what I will say. And the scripture even says, when we go before the faces of men, we do not think of what to say. This is not the preparation of my ego or my intellect, education, or intelligence. This is the fluid eloquence of the Ruach HaKodesh, the set-apart Holy Spirit of Yah that speaks and empowers. So coming back to, I think, my original intention, the idea of repentance and fasting is itself a yielding, a feminine surrender, a renunciation. There are some feminists who actually take issue with the word surrender in the context of feminine release and softening and opening and embodying. Surrender is a renunciation. Some feminists and what I believe to be narcissistic, as narcissism manifests in a female form, which in the future I will make some videos specifically about that. There is a reluctance to surrender the false perception of power and control. There is an aggressive chasing of the idea of power and control that is always illusory and elusive anyway. Because ultimately the creator has always been in control. The one who controls even the movements of the stars. Each particle of sand in the sea. The dancing of each blade of grass in the savannah. Repentance is a renunciation. It is a surrender. It is a surrender of self. It is a release of burden. It's kind of like the image that just came to my mind was, if you've ever seen the Addams Family, well, it wasn't the Chokey. Now I'm thinking of the movie Matilda with the Chokey, the torture chamber of Miss Trunchbull. I'm thinking back to the Addams Family, the device, the finger trap. And if you remember, the more you struggled to get out of the finger trap, the tighter its grip. And that is analogous to the demonic covenants, low vibrational frequencies and suffering that we find ourselves in as a consequence of the dysfunction of rebelling against our natural being and Yah's natural order for us. As I've said repeatedly, even on my Instagram page, sin is not this big spooky thing for us to be so ashamed and bogged down with self-condemnation and disgust and self-loathing. Sin, when we realize sin, we realize it is dysfunction. It is dysfunction. It is something that is not functional, not fruitful, not productive, not progressive for us. And Satan, in many ways, is an egregore of the collective human consciousness. While very real in certain senses, as in, yes, there are people who believe in this entity and do very diabolical things such as human trafficking, human sacrifice and rituals, including the temples of what we know as Planned Parenthood and other eugenics organizations that were themselves created by those who literally follow certain ceremonial practices and are in certain priesthoods and societies of the elite. Yah is guiding me to say certain things in a certain way. We know that the algorithm, the antichrist, the anti-Mashiach AI algorithm and YouTube, and they're flagging practices, all these very deliberately coded systems to prevent truth. So we have to say things a certain way for those with ears to truly hear. So Satan, although very real in certain senses, is an egregore of human consciousness, an amalgamation of everything that is dysfunctional, everything that is anti-life, everything that is against progress and fruitfulness, multiplication even. If we understand that Yah himself is life, period, everything that exists, his very name in the Hebrew, which will be very long to get into completely, but his very name encompasses existence itself. The verb to be, for my English majors and literary connoisseurs and linguistic aficionados, the verb to be is, was, will be. We is, we are, we were, we will, we do, we be. All these things. Existence in all tenses simultaneously. The present, the past, and the future simultaneously. Existence is his name. Existence. Simply being. And how marvelous a mystery is that, when we understand that to simply be is to be Yah himself, the creator, as his beloved creation. And that's the love. Going back to what I mentioned earlier in the video, that is the love that we all seek. That void that is itself an illusion, because he's always been there. So vast and infinite, majestic in his hugeness to fill us, in his sufficiency to satisfy us. We simply have to be and exist, to literally be him, to reflect him as his unity.
Be'alveyom avad zavil kom, mavad zavil kom, be'alveyom, be'myat yomi adamat ishmarazi, adamat ishmarazi, adamat ishmarazi.